Alright, good morning my viewers and subscribers. This is Emily Dreamfarm, and I'm here to teach most of us how to plant this plantain sucker, the in and out of it. First and foremost, you can see the farmland. We've done our clearing, and if you look around it, you will see some of the weeds and grasses that were brought out from the farmland. One of the reasons why we left some of these things is for the sake of mulching. So we are using it to mulch our suckers after planting. So now let's go into the business. Now, talking about planting of suckers, at first we talk about the depth of the hose where we are going to plant this sucker. Now, here is one of the holes where we are going to put the sucker. This is about 1 foot from the earth surface. Are you getting it? This is just 1 foot, and the depth 1 foot. The width, you can make it any width depending on the suckers you are making use of. So after this digging, we have two procedures whereby we plant the suckers. First, the first procedure is planting with the poultry droppings while it is inside the ground, and the other method will do it after planting. So what I want to talk about now is using the poultry droppings right inside the holes where we did for the suckers. Now, this sucker, after digging it, we apply some of the poultry droppings right inside the hole. Mix it up with sand, you know, before we plant. Are you getting it? This is the first method. I'm talking about the first method now. After applying the poultry droppings, because I didn't come with any of them for now, because I'm doing the second method, that's the one I'll use. But the both methods are okay. But that first method, the first method of applying your poultry droppings inside the ground before you plant, is in order to improve the soil nutrient, the one inside the ground, to help the suckers grow. And it is being carried out on lands that are not too fertile. Are you getting it? I've been planting in this land, I've been cultivating in this land for years, and I've seen the nutrient. I've done a lot of harvest in this particular land, and the soil is very, very good for planting. So now, after digging this thing, we now have to bring our suckers. Okay, I will take one of the suckers for just an illustration. Okay, this is what I'm going to do now. This, let me take one of these suckers here. This is a grass. This is grass, the one we brought out from the land. So now, this is the depth. Sometimes if you are not sure of your measurement, you can make use of this shovel. You take the depth of from here to here, just one of these, you can see it from here to here is enough, or you can make it extend it to the beginning of this head of the shovel. Are you getting it? So now, after digging it, what you do now is either you apply your poultry droppings here if the land is not that fertile. So this is our hybrid sucker we are going to put right inside the soil. This is a pure hybrid. Maybe during the harvest stage or when it keeps growing, you will see how it grows. Look at this one now. it has even started bringing out sucker. It doesn't take time to start growing. This is just one of the suckers still producing another sucker. So by the time we put it right inside the ground, one thing you need to know is that after digging out these things now, you don't put back that sand right inside the ground. So what we do, we dig from the side so as to create vacuum for water. So this is just it. Are you getting it? Gradually we are creating that vacuum for water. So by the time you do this, you compress it with your leg so as for it to gain more strength. Are you getting it? Make sure you straighten your sucker. Then you apply more sand to it. Are you getting it? So now, this is the vacuum for water. By the time it rains, the whole water that you get from the rain will now be stored here. Are you getting it? The whole water will be stored. There will be storage of water here, so that even when it is sunny, you still have more water retained. So gradually the sucker will not lose much water. So after doing this, you can now apply your droppings round the suckers. Then after that is when you can now make use of your weed to mulch it. Are you getting it? In order to prevent sunlight from drying the water, so it will help the water to gradually go down into the suckers. So this is what we are making use of. So even when it is raining, the water can still penetrate. Are you getting it? Are you getting it? So that is just it. So that is all for now. So I hope you understood the planting system. So this is how the method we use for our planting. So if you have any question to ask, you can reach me on 07063431615 or 08188335555. I still remain Emily Green Farm. Thank you for watching. Done.